the power of accommodation of I. So as you guys all know, right, that in case of I, what happens is that the image has to be formed at the retina, right? That is the point of formation of the image, or the position of the formation of the image is already fixed. The position of the formation of the image is fixed, right? That is, V is fixed, right? Those of you who attended the yesterday's session, right, those know that V is nothing but the image distance, right? So you see, right, that when we apply this particular equation, 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F, right? We will get that like 1 by V is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by F, right? Okay, so this is fixed, right? So this is constant, right? So for keeping this V fixed, the focal length has to change in accordance with the object distance, right? So when we are keeping the object nearby, our lens becomes thick and its focal length decreases. When we keep the object far away, the lens becomes thin, as you can see over here, and its focal length increases, right? Okay, so the ability of eye lens to become
so,
yeah, tell me.
You did 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. Why are we only shifting minus 1 by U to the left or to the right side?
No, I was just trying to show you that, like, suppose if I shifted 1 by U to the right side, then I know that you understand this, that V will be fixed in case of this particular scenario, because the image is always formed at the retina.
No, I didn't get you that. Do not understand.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so let me repeat the statement once again. So, so just tell me one question. So, in case of our eye, right, where is the image formed?
On the retina.
On the retina, right? So,
yeah,
we'll be able to see only if the image is formed on the retina, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So that means this particular distance is always fixed, right? In your eye, your retina is suppose at some certain distance away from your crystalline lens, right? So this particular distance is always fixed, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So you will always be able to see when the image is being formed at the retina. If it is not being formed at the retina, you'll not be able to see, right? Because this is the portion of your eye which is connected to the brain, right? So are you getting that? What I'm
yeah, I got it.
So yeah, okay then. So everybody else, you might have also got it. So what I'm trying to show you here, that V is fixed, right? So we get that 1 by V is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. So that means because it is fixed in case of I, so it is a constant. It will be some constant value, right? Let's say 2 centimeter, let's say. Okay, now if we increase or if we change U, that is, if we move our object near to the eye, or if we take our object away from the eye, right, the focal length of eye lens has to change. Are you getting that, Ashna? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yeah, yeah.
So that's why I told you, right, this is the special ability of our eye lens to become thick or thin, right? So let me tell you one more thing, right? I mean, I'm pretty much sure that many of you guys might have used this Nikon camera, right? So in Nikon, hello?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Hello, sir.
Are you guys there?
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yeah. Everyone is there.
Yeah. So we have over here, right? So I was explaining this to you, that if we change U, the focal length of eye lens will change. Okay? Right? So the eye lens has a special ability to change its focal length or to become thick or thin. So that is called the power of accommodation. Any doubt whatsoever for anybody?
No.
Till this point?
No, sir.
Okay then.